There, guys, I have a planner update flip-ish for you guys today. I haven't drastically changed anything in my planner, but I have made a few tweaks to kind of the content and how I'm using it, so I thought I would share with you. I did share this a little bit on an Instagram Live last week. Was it last week? Who knows what week it was, actually, by the time that I'm actually airing this video on YouTube. But from the time I was filming it, it's been like a week or two. One thing I have done is add a bunch of tabs. I do get asked about these a lot. Let me make sure I'm in here. They are these kind of flimsy white little tabs. They're like a piece of paper. So they're plasticky. I don't think they'll tear, but they're flimsy. So they don't have a whole lot of grip to them to pull around. But they're removable and they're inexpensive, and I'll try to be sure to have them in my Amazon favorites so you know what they are and where they are. But I was going to use this spread here at the beginning of the April plan book as kind of a journal, which is why I have this cute little Tinta character from Create with Pen. It says, "Let's journal." I was going to do like one line a day kind of thing in each of the boxes. And then I have a large family and everybody got like a 48-hour cold or something like that. And it almost started from like the first day of April, and like one kid got it and then the next kid got it and then the next kid got it and the next kid got it and the next kid got it. All five of my kids and then me, and then even in there my husband. So it was seriously like the 15th before I actually used my planner again. And by then, the month was so long gone that I just hadn't done anything in this spread. So maybe I will migrate this to my May book and try to do that. The other thing is, during my live, you guys gave me some great ideas. I thought about using this to track my kids' baths and showers. So once again, between five kids, two of them are completely independent as far as showers go. One of them, it needs a little help making sure her hair is completely rinsed and washed properly in the shower, so I help her. And the other two are in the bath stage. And I just do not have the time in the day to give everybody a bath on the same day and supervise it. We have one bathroom for all of our kids, so it's better to stagger them. And I'm realizing, like, today is a Wednesday. I couldn't tell you who had a bath or shower when last. Doesn't matter as much in the winter, but we're coming up on, you know, barefoot in the dirt season, sweaty, play at the beach outside all day season, and my kids are going to need very frequent cleaning. So this might be a good spread to actually track that. Another one is just incorporate this as kind of part of my faith and write down people I want to pray for and kind of have a schedule. Maybe I could set it up the month ahead. So that way every day I can turn to here and I can pray for different friends and family about different things. So I have my a completely separated prayer journal, but it's one of those things where sometimes I really use it a lot and I have it with me, and sometimes it's just kind of like another book to have sitting around. And so sometimes I kind of stick it more on a shelf so it's not in the way, and pray differently. I think there's a lot of room to tweak and adjust and you know, use it sometimes. So if I could take some of that information and put it here and something I use every day anyways, that, you know, anytime you can kind of condense, I think is helpful. I had this kind of gym schedule where I was going to do these arm exercises, and I started doing this at the beginning of the month, and I wrote down where I started so that way I knew to increase. And I also know that even though right now 5 pound weights, especially if I do the exercises correctly, they'll kind of burn out my muscles, but I really need 8 to 10 pounds. But that was, again, at the beginning of the month before everybody got sick. And when everybody's sick and you're helping little ones, you don't get to work out. So I had that tab there so I could find where, you know, what that was. And, you know, now it's gone. Here was a little heart tab. I added this so that way I could come to where my heart goals and almost like a mental goals and attitude goals really for the month were, and just kind of fleshing out a little bit of a routine and some different things. So this is the one that I refer to the most, and I like to have a tab there. And then I put another little tab here because I was starting to get motivated and really wanted a solid morning routine and an evening routine. And I wrote this, but you know how it is. I really struggle with when to work out, and I am so not a morning person. So even getting up before my kids is a challenge. No snooze is a challenge. To walk on the treadmill first thing in the morning is, I don't know. I mean, like, I can't think of a worse torture. So I can't quite bring myself to be motivated enough to actually do this, but it's in my mind. I'm chewing on it. I'm thinking about it. I'm maybe mentally preparing myself. So maybe I'll be doing this soon. Who knows? Put a little tab there. So that's why I have that. And then I was struggling to find my weekly overview for the current week and what day I was on. So I added this little thing with just a random coffee sticker from another one from Create with Pen. And then this one has just a little foiled coffee cup. It's from a random sampler. I don't even know the shop. And another one of those tabs, and I can just migrate these to the next day or the next week. But I'm really trying to utilize this weekly section. I am revisiting my love of sticky notes and having sticky notes everywhere. I love the look of it. I love how busy and kind of like this organized chaos look and lived-in look that it gives my planner. So I'm back to using as many as I want. I am trying to keep track of some things. So let me go like this. This is from yesterday, actually, and today. I can use my dot pen. It's not easy to get in and out of this pen loop, and I have shared where I got these pen loops before, but that shop no longer exists on Etsy. So I think the last time I wanted pen loops a couple years ago, I just searched elastic pen loop in Etsy, and tons of shops popped up, and I picked the ones I want, and I ordered like four or five of them. They've lasted me a couple years. I actually haven't been using an extra pen loop for a long time, but I decided I probably wanted to keep a pen with me like this, plus, you know, the one in the pen loop. So I dug this out of my stash and clipped it back on. These pens, I have a love-hate relationship with them. They work really well in the Strathmore paper from Designs by Planner Perfect, but they basically shadow and bleed through every other paper known to man, including thick paper. So I hate them for that because I want these little dots on things. I absolutely love how it makes the perfect little dot just like that. And it's amazing, but it just doesn't work on very many papers. Thankfully, it works in my main planner. So I'm trying to incorporate that. So I'm doing things like that. I'm writing down any main appointments we have, as well as trying to track some things. And then back here in my months, so as soon as I get my new monthly plan book, I will show you a flip of this. I bought this plan book. It has all 12 months. So it has the month, which is why this is where I use this all the time. I can't live without this. It gives me that big bird's eye view of how busy or not busy we are. In between were these little sheets I had made myself. I've talked about these before. I just made them on a Word doc or Google Doc to track where I am in my YouTube videos. So the name of it, when it's gonna air, have I filmed it, done the photo, edit, upload, and optimize. I couldn't find anything like this on the market, and so I just made my own and pasted them in. And then let me find a blank one. And then the other page that I had, or the blank spread I had in between the months, I was doing a checkbook register, and I don't need this. I wanted to use it, but I don't need it. And I have gone ahead and set up my entire book this way, and I don't think I need both of these or this many. And I want to start putting in this habit tracker. So I realized how I set this book up is basically not how I need it, and I need my planner to be functional. So I had some extra points at in my Designs by Planner Perfect account, which you can get points too. If you are a customer, you can sign up for their rewards program just like any other shop, and you can share the link with your friends and family. And if they use your link to purchase, then it gives you points, and you can save them up and redeem them just like any other shop. So what I want to do is do some tracking. I go off and on with trackers. Sometimes I use them. Most of the time I don't, but I'm really seeing the value in it right now. So at least for the next couple of months, I'm going to do a tracker. So I purchased these from Annie Plans Printables. It is dated with the numbers at the top. I actually, because I don't do the whole traveler's notebook, I just picked May, which was the first month where if I printed it, the first part and the second part would be on the same page. If you've ever printed TN inserts before, you know that in order to be able to put them together and make a book, sometimes the pages have to be split up because they're a double-sided book. So I never use them that way. I found this, I whited out the word May and I wrote the word April and I crossed out the 31st so I didn't forget that there were not 31 days. And I already have May, so I will just slice this and glue it in. I will have my new plan book though by the time I need, I hope, by the time I need my May one. So that's why I didn't put it in here. I didn't get this until I think the 13th. Didn't print this out until like the 13th. And so I back planned a couple of things, but I just didn't worry about back planning other things, even if I had done them. And right now I'm just doing a simple little dot, but it occurred to me that it would be super cute maybe to use a dot marker like this to mark them off. I have this thing with check marks. I think my check marks look stupid. I don't know why that's a thing. I don't know how a check mark can look ridiculous, but mine do. Mine look uneven. And for some reason that really bothers me. And then I was like, do I want to do like a slash through if I accomplished it for the day? But that's usually my signal that I didn't do something for the day. It's kind of like an X to me. I don't know. So I was like, I couldn't figure out how to track, how to use the tracker. It was bizarre. So I've been using dots. And I'm really trying to develop the habit of checking this frequently throughout the day and adding in dots on the things I've done. And I can see I'm already like 2 or 3 days behind. Oops. But it's a new habit and I'm learning and I really hope to develop it. And what's nice is I can change these up a little bit every single month to adapt for what I need, which has usually been my problem with habit trackers. I try to make them a little more permanent and you don't always need to track the same thing. Some things become habit and you don't need to track them until maybe they become a weak habit and you need to up that again or something. Or maybe you never need to track them again. So yeah, that's going to be a big change I'm going to make. Is kind of redo my plan book. I will back plan, especially the months, because I want to take any information from this book basically that I've already filled in. I'll put it in my new book, including back planning that I want to keep, and I will throw this away. I won't keep this. I won't keep two books, especially one that's partially done, because I do keep them as for like journaling and record keeping purposes about how my year went. So I like to have these on the shelf for every calendar year. So I will definitely be fixing that. So yeah, that's how I'm kind of changing and tweaking things. When I went to go get my clip for the back or for the extra pen, I saw my stash of little clips like this that I have kept over the years. I've had many more, but some I've just decided, you know, they don't fit my personality or my planner or my planning style or anything like that anymore. And so I pulled out a couple and I think they're super cute and they're actually partly functional because, oh, they were. This one's not holding it anymore. So this was holding my sticker sheet like this because I pre-washied, which I tend to do anyways, the sides, and I picked that this sticker sheet from Paper Minty Studio would correspond to the washi. This particular washi I just got randomly from Amazon. Again, I'll try to add it to my favorites. I felt like the colors went really well together and I really like to put decorative things on my page now, which is so weird. I never would have been a decorative sticker person ever before. And then I did the same thing for next week. So I already have my washi tape down and I used a different clip and I picked a sticker sheet that is decorative that I think will coordinate with my washi tape, and that's exciting. And like I said, I love that kind of lived in, things are kind of spilling over the side, clips here, washi tape, stickers, sticky notes. I've got some papers in the back, just folded up. One of the reasons I love the standard size is because if you take a sheet of paper, so this is an 8.5 by 11 paper and you take it landscape and you fold it into threes. It is the perfect size, the height of your planner. So you can stick it in the pockets, you can stick it in the back, and it just, it sits there nice and pretty, and you can keep, you know, loose papers if you need them or reference documents in there. And it's so amazing and it's so nice. So that's really all I wanted to show, is just kind of renewing my desire to use my planner. If you've been following my channel and even my Instagram since January, I've been a little unmotivated in my planner, but part of that is just I've hit this kind of gentle rhythm of life. I've been doing a lot of living, if that makes sense, and haven't needed a lot of planning. I have been trying to keep up with my memory keeping and journaling, and of course, you know, my planners, but mostly it's been memory keeping. I've been doing a lot of reading. I've even been writing a novel for the fun of it for myself, and that eats up a lot of my free time. So I haven't been playing in my planner as much, and I was just feeling like I needed to kind of refresh and regroup. So this was both functional to really dig in and find ways to use my planner in the season that I'm in. And it was also just to kind of renew my desire to want to hold and use and touch my planner by making it a little bit cute in how I like it and adding the tabs. And again, even using the sticky notes and the kind of chunky, chaotic feel really makes me want to use my planner and flip through the pages more, because I love what that does for the book and the pages. And so that's what I wanted to share with you. Just kind of this little almost like update how I'm using my planner. I will continue to keep you updated as I go throughout the year and continue to use my planner. And I encourage you to do the same. Use your planner in the way that makes sense to you, in the way that you want it, in the way that blesses you. So I hope this inspired you to make some tweaks and enjoy your own planner. Have a great day, you guys. I will talk to you in my next video. Bye.